Hello students, in this video we are going to see a definition of system and its continuous time and discrete time domain representation. So system can be defined as the process through which, if you pass the input, some processes will take place in order to get output. So if I define a system, it will be like this. I can say a system can be viewed as a process in which input signals are transformed or cause the system to respond in some way resulting into other signals which named as outputs. So system is a process and where input signals are transformed to give signals which we call as output signals. So the simple representation of any system will be like this. It is just related two signals. One we call as input signal, can be represented by x of t, and we will get other side output signal y of t. So x of t input signal is passes through this continuous time system. Same representation we can have for discrete time system as well. X of n is the input signal to get y of n as the output signal. We need to have a system which we call as a discrete time system, so that input signal is transformed to output signals. There are different connections of two systems. So in this part, we are seeing interconnection of two systems. The first interconnection type is a series, or also called as cascade. So, in a cascade connection, we have two systems connected like this. The signal flow is like this. X of t as the input passes through system 1, which will give you output, which we call as the intermediate output WT, which will drive another system, which is system 2, in order to get final output Y of T. So this is called as a simple series or a cascade connections of the system. Next, we are having parallel interconnection. So here an input is given to two systems simultaneously. And the responses of this are added. To get final output. So the signal flow is like this. This is X of T. Or input signal we are having given to two systems simultaneously. System 1 and system 2. System 1 will give an intermediate output as Y1T. And system 2 will give you intermediate output Y2T. Addition of these two take place to get a final output Y of T. Another type of a system we are having is a feedback system. So in feedback, a input is getting sum up with the same signal from the output, which is obtained by passing this to a system and then this output is sensed and passed through the summing junction by doing some process with the help of another system. So, signal flow is like this. X of T is the input. This is system 1. This is system 2. You will get a final output Y of T. It's passed to this system to give intermediate feedback signal, which is sum up with this, and error signal will be created, which is given to system 1 in order to get a final output. So here we have seen a system, a process where multiple time operations can be seen. A simple example I can take like this. For example, in case of an electric circuit, we are having a resistance, and if a current is passing through this resistance, I will get a voltage across it. So this I can consider as a simple system. How? This is the input I am giving and I am observing this output. So can I relate input with output? Yes. by Ohm's law, I can say voltage across a resistor will be nothing but resistor value multiplied by current passing through it. So what I'm having over here is one signal is coming, and something will happen to that signal to get another signal. So the first signal is this I, which is an input, and I'm getting over here V as the output. So what is happening over here? The input is getting multiplied with the R, so definitely this particular block we call as a system will have some constant or some function associated with it, so that once current is passed, something will happen, basically a multiplication happen, and we'll get output. So this is a simple example we have taken in order to elaborate how the system will look like. Thank you.